At 3 p.m., Byanyima arrived at Luzira Maximum Prison, where her husband, retired Colonel Dr. Kiza Besigye, has been remanded on allegations of treason. Byanyima, who looked calm, went through the normal procedures of accessing an inmate. After over an hour speaking to her husband, Byanyima was disappointed with the manner in which Dr. Kiza Besigye was treated while at Moroto Prison, where he was first remanded after being arrested. She described the situation as inhuman.
Complained about, and he is very suspicious about what happened in Moroto Police Station. First, that power was switched off around 8 o'clock, and for the rest of the night there was no power. He got a radio, a torch from a supporter, and he asked that a door to his cell, a second door, be locked, but they wouldn't lock it, and that door was opening to a quadrangle that was full of the militia that Kayihura uses to hunt him and his supporters down here in Kampala. They had been flown from Kampala and were there all night in the dark. He asked for the door to be locked. They shut it, they locked it, but when he woke up at night hearing movements, they had reopened it. And then he saw someone running out, creeping out into the quadrangle, who looked to be wearing a mask. So he was very suspicious of that night and what could have happened in that night.
Byanyima, who described her husband as a human rights fighter who is not about to give up on his cause, was however comfortable with the way Dr. Besigye is being handled in Luzira prison. She says the prison management has exhibited some level of professionalism by allowing Besigye some rights, unlike the police and the judiciary that are driven on what she termed as powers from above.
Besigye is comfortable, he's got a bed, he's got a mattress and his own beddings, and he's not complaining. Kiza Besigye is a tough freedom fighter. He finds those conditions very comfortable.
As a family, Byanyima said they will seek for bail, but she warned the police not to turn Dr. Besigye's home into another prison, as the case has been since the announcement of the election results.
Yes, it is supposed to maintain law and order, but it is itself lawless. You got a court order telling the police that this is a private home, but they continue to trespass on our home and to use it as an illegal prison.
Dr. Besigye is battling 5 treason-related charges that resulted from his demand for an independent international audit to be conducted before a new president can be sworn in, his intention to form a parallel government, and unlawful taking the presidential oath to execute the functions and duties of the office of the President of the Republic of Uganda, cases that Winnie Byanyima says the husband will overcome. Uganda's opposition leader was on Wednesday arraigned at Nakawa Chief Magistrate's Court and charged with treason afresh after his previous appearance in a similar court in Moroto District. Sam Paul Nahaima for NBS, live at 9.